lots of the gods. So it is good to be here in this evening to serve and preach you all the good news of the Lord Jesus Christ. So before starting, now it is the people of the world, especially the youth, with the God, give more observations, more give the eyes, especially for our youth, for the youth people. God loves mostly. So God focuses for the youth, on the youth. So today I'm going to discuss with you all about the youth. So before that, let us find out the scripture, what the scripture, what the Bible says. 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 11 to 12, I want to find out. These things command and teach. Let no one despise you, you are you. But be an example to the believer in what, in conduct, in love, in spirit, in faith, in purity. And also Ephesians 11, chapter 11, verse 9. Rejoice, O young man, in your youth, and let your heart cheer you in the days of your youth. Walk in the ways of your heart and in the signs of your eyes, but know that for all these things, God will bring you into judgment. May the Lord bless these scriptures.
Amen.
Amen.
So, nowadays the people, the youths, are forgetting day by day for the creators, for their own creators. Day by day, the people, even the Christians, the true Christians or the Hindus or any religions, the youth people, they don't give much attention or much importance in the religions or in the gods, because nowadays, most of the youth are getting interested in the net through social media, which are Facebook, WhatsApp, Twitter, Instagram. There is lots of apps with this. The people are passing there. They are doing the time pass most of the day, but they don't know who gave the beautiful day, who rise up from their sleep. They don't know who have given them the beautiful food and the beautiful life that they breathe every day. But beside of them, we are sharers. We know who gave us these all things, and we praise every day, we serve, we give thanks every morning, every evening, anytime. But there are thousands of new people, our brothers and sisters, who don't know to give the thanks for the day that the Heavenly Father provided them, but they don't know who have given them. Instead of that, they against their creators, they against the creators, the God, the Father of all. They against by doing the wicked things, by practicing the unrighteousness things, which in the eye of God, which was not supposed to be. So, they are sober, losing day by day. The youth people are enjoying in various way, in different way. Example, like practicing of occasions, like concert, or like drinking wine, like dancing, everything. There is a lot of activity skills nowadays for the youth people. So, what do I mean? Though they may enjoy their things, though they may enjoy the wicked things, though they may enjoy the right and righteousness things in the eye of God, which was not supposed to be, which the in the eyes of God, which was worse things. But I want them to realize, I want them to regret that someone is with them, someone is guiding them, someone is loving them. There are thousands of people who have posted on Facebook that they are alone. I am alone. But I used to comment them that you are not alone. Though you are far from your family, though you are far from your friend, but with you there is one person. There is someone with you always that love you more than you love your life as yourself. And I used to command them, there is one Lord Jesus Christ, always be with you. He is always with you. He never leave you. Though you may not know Him, though you may not know Him or what His glory have done upon you, but please don't call them yourselves, you are alone. There is always someone with you. He is omnipresent. He is spirit. You may not see Him, but He loves you. So there are thousands of people nowadays enjoying their life, enjoying the drinkings. Oh my God, they are drinking wines and dancing and practicing going to schools. Everything with these wicked things, they practice unrighteousness things. But they don't know who gave that day, who gave the day for them. And most of the people, when you try to correct them, most of the young people, most of them, even with a guns or voice, they will say to you, our life is our miss. This is the man that they have problem, that they have objective. Their motto is that my life is my wish. So I want to speak to them. If their life is their wits, and if they can do to their life anything what they want, then do they can escape from the dead? No, nobody cannot escape from the dead, because their life is not their wish, their life is the wish of God. Only the owners, the life owners, can handle their life in His wish. So our life is not our wish, my brothers and friends. Our life is, we are not owner of our life. Our life owners is the one Lord Jesus Christ. So there are thousands of people, they feel that their life is their wish. They have a lot of money to enjoy, to do anything, whatever they like, because they don't know the value of their life. What is the purpose of their life? There are thousands of people. There are thousands, a million, even million of young people who still practice those wrongs in a wrong way. So my brothers and friends, we need to save their life, as their life was in the midst of the oceans. Their life was in the darkness right now. Their souls will not be saved by that, what they practice. There is one of my friends who used to enjoy his life mostly. I used to say to him, friend, you need to repent your life. In this way, you will not be saved. Though you may be now happy, your life may be happy now. You may have a peaceful life right now, but after your death, think about that. What will happen? So he used to say that after the death, there is death. Nothing is there after death. But I say to you all, after the death, the life that you see, the life is my wish, the life is my whatever I want, I can do. The life, if the life is your wish, but your life will be a just man at the end of the time. Your life will be just, and you will be facing a just man. Think of that, my brothers and friends. One day you will die. Nobody cannot see that I will not die. We cannot escape from that, because our life is not our wish. We will die surely one day. So let us think, after the death, how shall we save our soul? How shall we can escape from our death, the everlasting death? How can we escape from that? Though we may not able to, even the believer, even the Christian priest, the true believer, will not escape the death from the flesh, but we can escape our soul from the death, everlasting death. How? The people will ask, how? How can we escape our life? How can we escape our spirit, our soul? There is only one way that we can escape from death. There is only by repentance we can repent our life. But it is difficult to repent from me. But it is easy for us to repent. We need to surrender our life. Those disenchantment will lead us into that one day. We need to know. I'm not saying, I don't mean that don't enjoy your life. We need to enjoy, yes, yes, even I do enjoy my life every day. But in which way we are enjoying? In which way we are supposed to enjoy? Now and then, whatever the people enjoy their life was not enjoying, they is not called enjoyment. They are killing themselves, they are being suicide themselves. They are killing themselves, their flesh. There are thousands of people. Even right now, they are enjoying their life, mostly with the alcohol and drugs, the youth people. So, brothers and my friends, we need to serve for all these people, for their souls. We need to go out and preach to them. We need to preach about this gospel, though they may accept or not. We need to preach. This is our duty for them, to bring them out from the darkness, to bring them out from the middle of the oceans. They are just flowing like a river, and they are blowing like the air in the atmosphere. So we need to bring them out. We need to take out them from there, and we need to save. As we are saved, we need to save them also, because now we tend to know that everything about the gospels, and we can say we get to know that we are saved by the repentance, by the baptism through the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We are saved, but they don't know still about that. So now we know this is our duty. As we know, and if we don't send others, we are against my God again. So we need to spare all the people who are thirsting. Some are searching for true God, but they don't find. So, we need to enjoy. The Bible says, but think that whatever you enjoy will lead you one day into the just man. So, the enjoyment after repentance, after baptism, after taking the baptism in the name of Lord Jesus Christ, if we enjoy with the Christ, if we enjoy with Him, that is the most extremely enjoyment. The flesh enjoyment is not enjoyment. The spirit enjoyment is the way how we enjoy, the way how we walk, the way how we pray. All these things is the main things that enjoy. So my brothers, all the people of the world, of the youth, for the youth especially, for our Lord's people, we need to save their life. Nowadays, day by day, the youth people are forgetting the old creator, the creators who created them, they don't know. Who gave them the beautiful day? Who raised them up from their sleep? They don't know anything. Instead of that, if they rise up from their bed, what is their first day? They do. They just enter their Facebook or WhatsApp. They discuss their works. Nowadays, it became daily day. So we need to save their life. We need to repent them. We need to into the light of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that they may also see the Lord Jesus Christ and walk in the way of truth and save their souls. So let us all keep this our mind anytime, because the young people, the young people are the generation for the future. And also, we young people are the teacher for coming generation. That is why we are for next and for coming. There are thousands of children, billions of children will be coming out. So we need to teach them. And also for future, we need to believe. Until if the Lord Jesus Christ does not come today or tomorrow, if we have still time, we need to be for the future. We need to make perfect for the next generation and coming generation. For this reason, the youth people are important in the gospel. The youth people are important in the eyes of God. So I request all the young people to repent, to leave their previous wicked and righteousness practice, and to follow the Lord Jesus Christ and His way, so that they all will be saved one day at the end of the time, at the end of the life. So this is my message today for all the people and for you. For you and me, even for my flesh. So thank you so much for all these things, and may God bless these scriptures.
Amen.